Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I believe we are live on LinkedIn, YouTube, Facebook with the infamous or soon to be famous Joel Felsenstein, also the founder and CEO of RockstarX. So if you haven't already, please go onto his page and go and check out RockstarX. In the description of this event, I've put a link to both his personal profile as well as a link to RockstarX, which only started a few weeks ago. We've just surpassed the 150 golden number so that he can start doing lives. So all I can say is watch the space, watch out, and be careful, because Joel has the bug. So, you know, anything is possible. It's going to be some interesting things coming ahead. So for those of you who haven't already seen my interview with Joel, recently, where you heard all the amazing things about Joel's life from the moment that he was born and cradled by Lady Diana to 18 years of living off wonderful pipes that kept him alive, to going into mainstream work and working at various different locations. And facing all those challenges as somebody who is, you know, autistic and atypical with atypical autism. And you're going to hear so much more about Joel's story over the coming weeks. We have got an 8-part mini series. So this is part one. And today we are going to be talking about music, as it were. And I'm going to go into a little bit more detail in a second. But firstly, Joel, I just wanted to welcome you. Thank you for taking the time. And I look forward to hopefully seeing you crack a smile a few times and showing the audience all the incredible things that you're about. So welcome to the stage. How are you today, sir?
I'm feeling rather good. And that's saying something, because my other computer in the background is giving off heat like there's no tomorrow.
Hopefully nothing is going to blow, or at least I hope not. So today we are going to be talking about the power that music has on society, but specifically on the neurodiverse. And for me, this is an exciting subject, because I've seen, you know, people that are like half dead in the world, like, you know, just that you can't even get them to budge or have a smile or have any form of excitement about them. And then all of a sudden a tune comes on, and then you start seeing them, you know, the fingers tapping, the foot tapping, and all of a sudden, you know, their attitude and the way they look at life all of a sudden gets this bit of spark. So I want to tell you about something very, very quickly before I forget, for those of you who are listening. Joel and I had the wonderful opportunity of doing a very long road trip recently, where we were discussing, you know, the impact of music. Joel and I were discussing putting a playlist together for not only for people that are neurodiverse, but really some balance for the neurodiverse. But they can also apply to just anybody. And yeah, initially there were like 5, 10, 15 tunes. Joel, where are we sitting now? How many songs have you put on that playlist?
Any minute, I'll check. I can't remember the exact number, but hold on a minute. Let's pretend to add this to my playlist, even though it's already there. 159.
159 songs. And I can tell you something. Just a little bit of history on my side of things. My brother he's got something called Fragile X, but he's also on the spectrum for autism various other labels, as it were. But I decided to test the theory of Joel's playlist. And I tell you what, the people in traffic definitely looked at us like we were off our rockers. Because we were properly going mental in our car, just jamming to all these different tunes. And there's, you know, there's, I think, something for everybody in there. Joel, so I want to go to you on that quickly. I mean, talk to me about the power of music and what it's meant to you.
The power of music is, well, that it's had so much studies around it, and it's power, not a power, not just with the neurotypical and the neurodiverse people, but how the entire world communicates. I think it's the only language which is understood by the entire world without having to use Google Translate or any other translating application. And for me, it started before my formal lesson. It started at the age of five, but it started way before that. It started, I think, at the age of two, really. And it's helped me really communicate what I was feeling growing up, and really helped me develop into, Mum thought it was just a phase. This banner says differently.
So when you say she said it was just a phase, you know, what kind of age do you think that was, that music was just a phase for you?
About the time when we got the first drum kit.
Oh, wow. So this is, let me recall, 7, 8 years old?
No. The first drum kit, in inverted commas, it was made by a company back in the 90s called Thunder. It produced toy drum kits in Japan and all that stuff out of their Japanese manufacturers. Mum thought it would stop there. Then at my bar mitzvah, six friends bought my first fully fledged drum kit, and I briefly then went over to, I've been through four kits, really. This is the fourth one. I briefly went through Mapex. I've now got DW.
So what's the story? Yeah. Why are you going through so many drum kits, Joel?
I've stuck with this drum kit because, believe it or not, I walked into Wembley to get some new drum heads, and I looked over at the drums, as you can't fail to not look over, because you walk in, drums over, drums on your right, drums on your left. I looked over to the left, and if instruments can make someone do this, it'll be musicians, and I wolf whistled.
You wolf whistled in a music store?
At the drum kit, yes.
I've heard a lot of interesting things, but wolf whistling at as a music store is definitely a new one to me. wow. Okay. So talk to me about, you know, the power of music and how that has been impactful for yourself, and then we'll go down into just using examples of what type of music is, you know, kind of gets you going and has you alive. We have a great question from Don. Did you just see that?
No, I can't see anything.
Okay, so Don has just asked you a question. How many guitars is enough? Just one, or?
Well, I've got two. My neighbor who bought me the drum kit ended up with about 7 or 8, but by then his wife had enough. So every time he got a new one after that, he had to get rid of one. It was out with one, or he could not continue to grow it.
Oh, that sounds far too restricting.
Yeah, for exactly. Me.
Don, we're going to have to hear from you in the audience there. How many guitars have you got? Andrea has just commented, put a Stradivarius in front of me and I'll definitely whistle. That is awesome. You know, music is such a powerful thing. And, you know, a man that's been through four drum kits. And as you will see, if you haven't noticed already, if you're a music fan and you know anything about drumming, you'll notice some of the biggest brands in the world just happen to sponsor Joel as well, which I must say that takes quite some doing. So clearly, you know what you what you're doing. And I think we're going to, I know Joel's been asking me, but I think we are going to have to do one of our lives live in your drum studio and your guitar studio so that we can see you in action. So that'll come soon. So talk to me about some of the music that you've put on that list and what they mean to you, and why other people should go and check it out. And what we'll do as well is we'll share a link in the comments to this playlist. It is absolutely epic. But if you are listening and you've got a song that, you know, gets you out of your seat and just makes your day, put it in the comments and let's hear it. Hear what you've got over there. Don has trimmed his guitars down to 6.
Oh,
Don, you're gonna have to share some pictures, my friend. Awesome. So Joel, tell us about some of the songs that you've put on that list and why.
Okay. Didn't know I was in school, but okay.
Did that come across as a bit teacher like?
And why?
Apologies, not intended.
The two recent songs I put on there, and I'm shameful to put one of them on there because it's not associated with any football team I support, sadly. And that is the new track number 8, which is You'll Never Walk Alone.
Oh, Liverpool, and I'm not even a Liverpool fan.
Unfortunately, I cannot say.
So talk to me about that song. What is the meaning for you with that, and why is it so powerful?
Well, I need to first of all process the fact that as a United fan, I put that song on my playlist.
We are going to have some backlash over here when people start watching this later on, Joel. But for now, we'll cope. We'll say it didn't happen. Move on.
No, I mean, the message is that in that song is in the title. And I think that song speaks for everyone who is feeling like they are on their own. I think to get the full definition of what that song's about, you would have to dig up Jerry and ask him.
Well, hopefully we're not going to be doing any of that, because there's a whole stack of laws prohibiting that kind of behavior. You know, that is a powerful song. And I remember being, you know, in South Africa working with a Hard Rock Cafe and Sports Cafe and various other big chains. And I had a general manager that I worked for, John, who was an incredible Liverpool supporter. But he used that song, and this is just how powerful music is. You know, he used that to bring the team together. Now, we managed and ran a restaurant of 500 to 1,000 people on any given night. And you know, when we got the troops together before the madness happened and people started coming in, we would all stand there and he would put that on as our kind of start of the day anthem. And it was just, you know, something every time that song came on, people just click straight in. It's almost like that kind of programs them, gets their state ready, and they just want to, you know, they want to take on the world. And you've put some other big hitters. What other big hitters can you think of that you've put into the list that people should go and have a listen to, or another reason to go to that list, or even comment about, you know, the big songs that they want to add to that list?
Well, the ones that I've put on, I have gone a bit mad on the list and it's still growing. I put on recently is of course The Doors, Break On Through to the Other Side, Against All Odds by Phil Collins.
Oh, and powerful one. Keep going.
Can't Break Me Down, Billy Idol. Kryptonite by Three Doors Down.
I know we've got Man in the Mirror on there. I don't know if that's...
Yeah, that's on top, yep.
Yeah, although, you know, I don't want to get into a whole Michael Jackson conversation right now.
Eric Clapton's Changed the World.
So, you know, one of the things that I've noticed when, you know, when it comes to music is for everybody, it impacts differently. Yeah. But what is the, you know, if you could describe the kind of power that it has for those of people that are, for specifically you as an example, you know, being part of the neurodiverse banner, as it were, just meaning that you are programmed, you know, a little bit better than most. What would your world be like without music?
Far less colorful. I mean that in the literal sense, not the words, not the vocabulary sense. And a lot more black and white. And
do you think you'd be as positive as you are? Because for those of you who don't know Joel, he's one of the most positive guys I know when it comes to, you know, if you just know like a small pinch of the challenges Joel has faced through his life. And yet every time I speak to you, Joel, it's just like, yeah, what next? What are we doing? How are we going forward? How are we going to help people? What are we going to do? And it's like the energy, you know, on screen, we're still working, you know, on Joel showing that enthusiasm, but on the phone, my gosh, or one-on-one, killing it. Joel, over the last, what's it been? What are we in now? May? So only a couple of months, you've gone from having never networked ever before,
yep,
to, you know, doing a few networking events, talking in front of other people. You've done, I don't know, what's it, 4, 5, 6 lives now, with different people. You're running your own meetings. You're doing all these like crazy things that were never part of your life even 2 months ago. And you've built RockstarX's company page, you know, from, you know, you've gone going through LinkedIn training with myself, and you just go and apply. And it's like you've got to kick everybody's backside. I can't imagine that your life would be even remotely the same without music.
No, it wouldn't be the same. It would certainly be duller. And coming from a family of teachers, that is saying something.
Well, it depends what you're teaching, I guess.
Yeah. So my parents, both teachers who taught at school, my sister's a personal trainer and also a singer. My other sister is a teacher at school. I mean, the only two creative people in the family are me and my Maple Martin.
Okay. And you're the noisiest, is that correct?
Yes.
No hesitation whatsoever. Straight into yes. So tell me what, you know, from a music perspective, I mean, let's talk through that very quickly, because I know Don mentioned the guitars as an example, and Andrea mentioned the Stradivarius, which, that's going to take me down a whole rabbit hole and I'm not going to come back. But, you know, when it comes to, you know, let's go to your guitar side of things, because you're clearly an electric man, even though I have an acoustic, and we'll talk about that another day. Why electric?
For the classical guitars, I couldn't get the fingering technique right on the right hand, let alone the left. And the electric guitar, let's face it, you have more fun on it. I mean, you can if you're playing flamenco all your life, go ahead, get a classical guitar. But if you're playing, if you want to play solos and all that stuff, and I like to make the guitar scream.
I have quite, seen, and you do literally. It well.
And I did that once in a lesson, and I didn't quite know why my teacher's several years older than me, right? And for some bizarre reason, he said, I won't know whether to lie, did that guitar just have a guitar gasm? I'm like, what?
What? Hold on, censorship. Where's that button? Oh, dear. Well, clearly you managed to get that guitar to do some things that most people wouldn't.
Yeah.
And I've seen you in action. So, you know, one of the things I suggest, if you're watching this either now or later on, you're watching the replay, go and comment below, you know, what you want to see Joel do some covers on his electric guitar. And he'll go and post some of those either on his personal profile or potentially on RockstarX, where I think you're going to see a lot of interesting things over the next next few months. Now, tell me, Joel, with regards to your kind of your vision for helping people with autism, yeah, or being, you know, neurodiverse in any way through the beauty of music, I know you're looking to connect with other people, you know, whether it be on LinkedIn or any other platform,
yeah,
that can help you with your journey on RockstarX. Whether that is, you know, people that offer things like music therapy, or people that offer, you know, music retreats and do that kind of thing, where you can have some music events that you can put together. Is that me with a background noise? Oh.
That's a plane going past my window. Yeah.
Ah, the beauty of where you live is literally under an airstrip. So, where they take off and land. I better get done before your next plane leaves, Joel. you know, what kind of people would you love to see, you know, reach out to you and connect with you that could help you on this this journey with RockstarX?
I think people from the music side and people from the entertainment as well, like, I don't know, Jack Black's a bit of a tall order, but someone, I mean,
if you know Jack Black, anybody, you know, just drop his number in a DM.
Yes. Or someone who people of influence. I mean, I'm just a average person at this point. I'm not there yet. If I was,
well, you know, it's an interesting thing that you say, an average person at this point, and you know, I think every one of us evaluates success in life differently. You know, for me, you know, I have, you know, the all these different challenges that I've faced in my life, and just being alive and waking up in the morning, seeing the sunshine, for me, hey, success. And then you have other people that wake up in the morning and go, not another 10 million. Well, I guess then, you know, I'm not successful. And each one of us have a different measurement of success. And I must be honest, if I look at what you've accomplished, Joel, you know, the fact that you were literally being fed by pipes and you couldn't survive without these things plugged into your body up until the age of 18. And now that you've found another way to survive and, you know, feed your body with the right things in order to keep you alive, on a daily basis, so that you don't have to walk around with all these tubes and wonderful things in there. And, you know, all the other challenges your body has been through with the different syndromes that you have. And, you know, yet I know, for those of you who don't know, I went for a viewing of a wonderful venue called Sawmills, down in Cornwall, recently with Joel. And, needless to say, I'm not, you know, and I'm not going to go into it now, but I'm not as fit as I should be. And, we got offered the opportunity to walk around the grounds of 30 acres of woods. And I turned around and went, oh no, I'm not so sure. Joel might not want, and Joel was like, cheers, bye, see you up the hill. And gone. And he left me behind. And I was like, damn, Joel, you were supposed to turn around and use some excuse, but there wasn't any. And I Needless to say, I think I crashed. What is it? 2-3 days afterwards that I just physically couldn't move, trying to stay out and keep up with you, Joel. So you know, definitely anybody in the music industry who feels that they could, or they already have some form of a program or system or something in place for helping people that are, you know, classified as neurodiverse, and being able to help, you know, whether it be children or adults, and educate and use some form of therapy or retreats for music, you know, please get in touch with Joel. We're currently in the process of putting you know, different business opportunities together that ultimately are going to serve the neurodiverse as well as those that are, you know, the what do you call the people that are not neurodiverse, Joel?
You don't want to know.
I'm going to be careful because you know, I've got dyslexia and a few other things, so apparently I fall within that that category. But it's yeah, we all have these wonderful labels. I call them, you know, I've got post-it notes and all kinds of things. So I can call myself what I want every other day. You know, it's really an opportunity to be able to use the power of music to make a difference in people's lives, yeah. But also help people in mainstream jobs out there. So, you know, helping neurodiverse people get involved in the gaming industry, as an example, you know, the music industry, in the entertainment industry, and various other jobs that, you know, neurodiverse people excel in. And in a way that it doesn't make everyone fit the cookie cutter process. So Joel, I'm conscious of time. Give me some facts and figures that you know, you think people should know about when it comes to the impact of music.
Well, we don't need to go very far into the facts and figures, Mac. There's a lot of celebrity musicians that either identify rumored as or has been diagnosed. One of which, and I was very surprised to hear about this, was the lead singer and the founding member of Jefferson Airplane.
Okay. I wasn't aware.
Marty Bellen, yeah.
And you know, give us some other interesting facts and figures that you find interesting and people should be aware of.
I find that even if you can't talk, and I'm going to use my cousin for this particular bit.
Absolutely.
Even if you can't talk, you can still you can still talk. But not necessarily in the conventional sense. You got my cousin who's in the band called the Autistics, and I sent you one as well, Mac, of a valedictorian using speech recognition, text-to-speech, giving a speech to her to the entire Roland's college.
Oh wow. So, you know, what I'd like you to do, Joel, is after this, chat, is go and drop some of those interesting articles and things just into the comments so people can go and read about that, because there's so much that happens. And, you know, over the next 7 to 8 weeks, you and I are going to uncover different topics. If you go and look in our in the description of this event, you'll see some of the other topics we're going to be discussing. And just broadening out our conversation around neurodiversity, autism, and music, and the challenges that all of that faces as well. But it's, you know, there are some really frightening articles and statistics when it comes to how people with you know, autism as one, mm-hmm. but many other neurodiverse categories. Also, you know, the things that they face on a daily basis, And one of the things I was quite surprised about that you mentioned, that in today's day and age, that there's still this massive stigma that people don't want to necessarily, I can't even pronounce my, you speak, I don't know, this water has got something in, necessarily, that they don't want necessarily want to divulge, as an example, in fear of the fact that they're going to be missing out on opportunities or seen as, you know, too different or not be understood. And I still believe there's so much education to be done around autism. You know, I go out with my brother-in-law and he's 6'3", a beast of a man, and he's got something called Fragile X. And if he, and I'll share a video one day, but he was walking through a town center. I think it was, I can't remember. I'm not sure, Brighton or somewhere. It was on one of the beach, the cities near the beach. And, you know, they were playing live music in the city center, like as people were walking through. And the next thing, he just started jamming and dancing and going mental. And people were like, oh, what's he doing? And, you know, it like took a lot of people by surprise. Here's this massive 6'3" beast of a man, and he's doing air guitar and all kinds of things. But immediately he went from a boring walk through the city to he was just like, you know, supercharged. And, you know, the awareness and the education around autism still has got so much to do. I mean, what do you think are the best ways right now that we can go about educating people? What do you think are the easiest routes? I know music is definitely one of them, but what else?
Communicating with not necessarily people who have got autism because they've got it, but getting those people in front of a camera or in front of something, and do exactly what I believe we are doing with Jonathan Cohen in the coming weeks.
Yeah, I think that's going to be interesting. Watch out for that. There's going to be an interesting video. Joel's looking for collaborators to do a recording of what's it called? This Is Us?
No, This Is Me.
This Is Me. This Is Me. Well, it's not really. It's going to be This Is Us. Yes. Because there's going to be more. It's not going to just be one of you.
I can't change the song title. Is.
Well, you know, This Is Me, the beast of a ballad. But getting people involved in that. So if you want to be involved in doing that video recording with Joel and Jonathan Cohen, you know, if you're a musician of any kind and you want to get involved, whether you want to, you know, sing in the background, where you want to play guitar, play a flute, I don't care what it is, you know, let's get hold of Joel, let's put it together, and let's see if we can have some fun putting this into motion.
Yes, so yeah, songs like that, and have fun. Or I mean, I'm a firm believer of actions speak louder than words. If you can do something, it's not gonna matter if something on the wall tells people that you can do something, because that can a certificate can say you can do something, and then you could be utterly useless.
Oh, believe me, I have seen people pass certifications in mainstream corporate, and then when it comes to the application and real life, and this is why, you know, and don't get me wrong, I believe in education, and I feel that education is vital and extremely important, but I also believe that there's a different way for each one of us to learn. And I know from speaking to you, Joel, you know, hands-on learning by doing, you know, right, getting your feet and your hands dirty and just climbing in and learning like that has been, you know, the way that you've learned to do things like video editing, play guitar, play the drums, and a ton more that, you know, just keeps coming out about your like, incredible tool set of skills that you have in the background. So, you know, wrapping up, what are your final words to everybody? You know, when it comes to music, you please need to go and put that Spotify list into the chat for everybody. If you don't, I will, so that everybody can go and listen to that. And I bet that's going to make everybody's weekend, that playlist.
Well, that's longer than the weekend. It's 11 hours. So
the weekend's...
Yes, but you won't listen to... No one listens... I didn't even listen to that in 11 hours straight, no.
5 hours tomorrow, 6 hours today. We'll do
it. Yes, I mean, people... I'm going to take driving, and I'm sorry to everyone who can drive. I'm sure everyone's an excellent driver, but there are some idiots out there which you have to ask, how the hell did you pass the driving test? It's exactly the same with actions speak louder than words. If you're shit at something, your actions can speak far more than, or if you're good at something, your actions can speak far more than any piece of paper.
Absolutely. And I think, that's one of the things that the education process needs to look at with regards to having more resources to be able to teach people in a way that's best for the student, not to force a square peg, as they say, into a round hole. Firstly, it hurts, so don't do it. Secondly, why do we continue to do this? And I think the pandemic has just brought about such an incredible opportunity for education to be disrupted. And music as a big part. I know so many parents who, all these, these gym programs that came out, but those gym programs would have been nothing without the music and the upbeat tempo and the things that go with it. Just having a little break where the kids can go and listen to their music or go on the earphones. And you look at platforms like TikTok, which is mostly music, and a lot of it's, beyond my mind, because I kind of look at it and go, somebody actually spent time recording this? It's a different story. But there are some incredible things on there, and a lot of it's there to make you feel better, make you laugh, and also stimulate that musical side of things. So, music everywhere we go, there's a theme song in and out, and that's something we're going to have. So, Joel, I'm gonna challenge you to write a intro and outro music for the rest of this series. So for the next 7 episodes, to have your own little jingle in and out. No pressure. Okay, so conscious of time, and I don't want to. We can babble all day, and I promise you, if I didn't watch out, Joel would have me on here 24 hours. But we're gonna call it a day now. I want everybody who's watched and got this far, please do us a favor. Reach out to Joel, comment about your experiences in the comments as well. We've met through the conversations Joel and I've had so many incredible people that have reached out and gone, hey, FYI, I've got autism, or I'm dyslexic, or I've got ADHD, or I've got whatever their neurodiverse challenges. And it makes us all individuals. It makes us all incredible people. And just learning how we can communicate and work together is where the magic happens, but we have to allow and be open to those. So share your experiences. I'm blown away with the amount of incredible people out there that are trying to make a difference in their own way. So go and shout that out in the comments, send us a DM, I look forward to our next event coming up soon. Make sure that you follow the hashtag lifehacks with Mac, because that will be tagged every single time we do one of these mini series on Lifehacks with Mac, and also the LinkedIn expert. But the Rockstar X is the focus of this mini series. The mini series' title is, Joel? Let's see if he remembers.
It doesn't get any easier when you get older.
You've got to fight for your right. And there's one of those songs in that playlist as well. So Joel will be sharing that as well. So, and if you just think about that title of You've Got to Fight for Your Right, every single person, we're all fighting every single day to be able to, you know, feel, you know, like we count, feel like we're making a difference, feel like we've helped others, feel like we are appreciated, that we loved, etc. So, you know, this is Joel and I talking about his right to party, whether it be in the musical world or working, you know, as a CEO of his own company and helping other neurodiverse people also excel in this world and do what they specialize in and the magic they want to bring to this world. So thank you all for listening. Much kudos to all of you. Joel, always a pleasure. Love thank the you. Smile. It just, you know, every time I speak to you, the energy is radiating. And I look forward to the next thing that buzzes and comes flying out. So much excitement. Looking forward to the next one in the series. Everybody go and have an incredible weekend. And we look forward to speaking to you again soon. Joel,
yes.
All the best.
You too.
Thank you so much. Cheers, everybody.